Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this Canva 2.0 tutorial, you're going to learn exactly how to put together your next ebook using Canva. So make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description to skip around the video for design inspiration, along with some other helpful Canva tutorials to design other awesome things using Canva 2.0. Now, before we dive into my screen, there are two big things we need to know. Number one, Canva has a 30-page limit. So if you have a very long ebook, you're going to have to use something like smallpdf.com to export everything, all of your Canva designs as a PDF, and then put them together so everything is in one PDF. So this is very easy to do. Number two, if you're doing anything with Kindle, please don't use Canva. I get a lot of questions about this. Kindle is not going to format properly from a PDF. You need to be using a plain text Word document, and then it can be properly formatted into the EPUB format. You can make your individual images that you're going to put inside of your Kindle book, but don't use Canva for your entire book. So with that, let's go ahead and jump in, and I'm going to walk you through the best templates for eBooks. Now, if you're going to be designing an eBook specifically for people to use on mobile, then I recommend going with the Instagram story, Facebook story, or your story or WhatsApp story templates. You can go ahead and check those out on your own. For this particular instance, we're just going to be assuming that we're going to be doing a normal 8.5 by 11 US paper. So the first place you wanna look is inside documents. You're going to click on report. So you can hold control or command on a Mac and control on the Windows, and go ahead and open this up in a new tab. I'll go through these templates in a second. Then inside of personal, a good place to look is book cover. And actually that's going to be my top pick for now. I no longer recommend starting with magazine cover like I used to in the past. Under education, you're going to want to check out the yearbook and table of contents templates. And then under marketing, you're going to want to check out newsletter and proposal. And so what I mean by check out is just go ahead and hit Control or Command, open these up in a new tab, and just scroll through all the templates to get some inspiration and design ideas. One of them is bound to stand out at you, and that'll be the one that you'll use. So I'm actually going to use the book cover, but I'll just scroll through here very quickly so you can see there are a lot of template options, and this is what makes Canva so valuable, because you don't have to come up with your designs from scratch. I will go through how to put together your actual content pages from scratch, but when it comes to your cover, there are plenty of examples here. So I'm actually going to skip over this one. We'll come back to table of contents. And then the other one you want to check out is here we have the magazine covers. This used to be the one that had the best, but I think now these are more, I use them more for kind of lead magnets or really short guides or PDFs, not so much full-blown eBooks anymore. And then you'll also want to check out the proposal templates, which is another great thing if you're just creating some quick guide and not like a full-blown eBook. And then finally, checking out the newsletter templates if you're looking for something fancy with your content pages. I'll get to more of that in a bit. So let's start by choosing our cover, right? So cover is kind of the most important part of the book. It's books are still judged by their cover. So I'm going to scroll up here. They have a section for business. So I'm going to click on business cover. You can also use the search box to look for things, and you're going to want to be very broad with your search terms. So for example, searching marketing would be too specific. You'd want to search something like business or office, or search for food or recipe, workout, fitness, something like that. Very, very broad. Don't be specific. Their tagging system is very broad. So I just scroll down here and choose one that I want. To save us time, I looked ahead of time. So I'm actually going to go ahead and start with this cover. It's going to be very simple. And then we can go ahead and change some things up. You can always come up here to change your fonts. They have so many different fonts. There's a lot of options here. We can come in and change the size. And of course, you have more colors, every color under the rainbow, and you can bold and italicize. For some strange reason, Canva doesn't have underline and they don't have strike through. You can also click this to automatically make everything all caps, which is kind of cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and blow this up a little bit so it's easier to see on the screen. And I'll just go ahead and type in our name. Come down and change up the title, fast track your, let's make this about YouTube. I like doing YouTube stuff. Your YouTube growth. Oh no, it's more than one line. So we'll go ahead and highlight it. Trying a different thing, a couple things didn't work. So let's bring the font down to, let's just do 32. Now that's too small, so we'll play with the font a little bit. Give our book a name. And then come down here and, oh, they already have a by, so I guess we better change what's at the top. I'll put my name there, and then we'll change this to just say it's part of a collection. How about that? So 5-step content machine by Jason Whaling, and then we'll just go ahead and delete this. I don't have a cool testimonial yet. So we'll go ahead and put an image in here. So let's go to elements and we'll add something about YouTube in here. So search for YouTube. Then we got a nice little play button. So we'll just click and drag that down here. And I'll make this full screen so you can see the whole thing. And here we go. There's our cover. Aspire Notebook Collection, Fast Track Your YouTube Growth, 5-Step Content Machine by Jason. All right, cool. So that is really all you need to do for your book cover. So let's go through one more example real quick here, and then we'll move on to the table of contents. So let's try one that will require an actual image, right? So let's try this one. And first of all, I'm gonna change the blue. So I'll click on the actual element and I can come up here and change it to my company blue. We'll change all of this color to the actual blue of the company and change the title. And realize that the blue looks really bad, so we'll change it back to orange, so it kind of works. Obviously, play with the colors a lot more. I won't waste your time here. Just type in another name of a different product that I have. And then we could come down here and give it a subheadline, and I'll go ahead and change this bottom to match the orange. There we go. So we'll match the company orange, and we'll change this to match the company orange. And of course, we could change the background image to something that shows a video, and you can go to something like Unsplash, Pixabay, or pexels.com to get free images that you can just add to the background. And the easiest way to do that is you'd be able to upload them here, and then all you have to do is click and drag. So I'm gonna go to a folder where I already have some backgrounds, and here's one of a camera. So all I have to do is click and drag it over, and it will automatically put it in the back for me, just like that. So now I've got a nice camera. Probably do a little bit more, but there you go. You see, we made two covers very, very quickly. So we have our second one here, YouTube Content Machine 2.0. We just dropped in a background image that was relevant to creating content, which was a camera. And then we have one that is super simple, just with an icon. And that's really all we need to do. So we have our covers down. Let's go ahead and do our table of contents. So this is something pretty ninja that you can do. I'm going to come over to this design, which is a bunch of table of contents templates. Now, what's awesome with Canva 2.0 is you can move things from one design to another. So we're going to go through table of contents and we'll choose one that we really like. Now, I've gone ahead and done some pre-work here, and I like the way this one looks. So I can go ahead and make all the changes I need to this table of contents, save it as its own file. So I'll come up here and just say something simple so I can remember what this table of contents is called. And then I can come over to my current design and I can refresh the page. So now I'll have the ability to import what I just saved into my ebook cover design. And after refreshing the page and waiting about 90 seconds, we can come back in here and we're in our covers. We're back to our covers now, and we can go to folders and we can click on all your designs. And up here, you can see here's the table of contents that we just saved in the other tab right here. So this is the table of contents we just saved. And now we're going to be able to import it into our design here. It automatically resizes as close as possible. And now we've essentially taken one of the table of contents templates and added it into our ebook. So we'll do a quick jump ahead to me reformatting this. And just like that, I was able to easily change the colors. So all you have to do to change the colors is click on the element and then come up here to the background color and change what it looks like. So we can just change it to yellow, we can change it to red, a different red or turquoise. In this case, we're just using our brand blue. And then you can also click on individual elements like this one and come up and change some of the confetti. So something I really like about Canva with these pre-done elements is you can actually manipulate the colors of some of these pre-done graphics so that you can make the colors fit. So I've gone ahead and changed this. So all that we need to do here is we'd go ahead and give our chapter titles. And just like that, research, create, rank, promote, we have our table of contents. Of course, you can go through and create your own table of contents with whatever template you think is best. Now comes the important part, and this is where you're going to save yourself a lot of time and headache by following what I'm about to go through. And that is creating a template for your content moving forward. So the best way to do this, I'm going to show you two or three different templates you can put together. Create a new blank page, then come into shapes. And what you want to do is essentially think about it creating a frame. So you have a lot of content and maybe you have some images for your ebook. So now it's time to create a frame for all of that content. And the simplest way to do this is with some basic shapes. So there are two pieces of information you need in your frame. You need a page number, and then if you're going to put your logo or the title of your book, you can also do that. So in this first example, I'm just going to use a basic square. I'm going to center it at the bottom, bring it down, use my company color. We'll do orange. Let's be fancy. Let's be different today. We'll use orange, and then I'll pull in another one, and this time it's going to have a nice little border, and I'll shrink it down, put it in the center, and then change it to blue, and then I would put the logo or the name of the book in here. So we're actually gonna do logo, so I'll go to my designs and find a folder with my logo in it, make the logo nice and small, and then put it in the box. And then that would be essentially everything we would want to do for our page. I know that seems super simple, but when it comes to designing your ebook, the table of contents and the book cover, that's where you want to spend all of your time. After that, just putting together a very basic page template that you can easily copy and paste your content into is going to save you a lot of headache, and you don't want the design to distract from your content. Now, something else that I really like to do, we'll go back up here to elements, is to shrink a square down up here and then use that to put in the page number. So we'll come up here, shrink this box down to a little square, then we'd come in and click add subheading and go ahead and create our page number here. And one of the things you do want to focus on is make sure that you're using one or two fonts. It's very easy to have every page have a different font. Especially if you're using templates. And let's bring this up a little bit. I think 28 would be a good size for that. So now we have our page number. And if we go back down to fit here so you can see the whole thing, we have our page number and we have the bottom of our page, plenty of space for content. Now, this might be a little too plain for you. Okay, let's get a little more fancy. So I'll click on add new page. And by the way, we can just hit duplicate and get the same thing, right? But let's go ahead and start from scratch again. This time, I'm going to have a much more in-depth design here. So we'll go ahead, we'll use this guy again. And this is something, of course, you can use as well, just copy for yourself, and use these to create sections. So this will be section one and section two. And we'll go ahead and change this guy to, let's do turquoise. And then something I also like doing is you can come up here to transparency and then pull the transparency up and down. So I'm gonna pull the transparency down to about 50, and then I'll do the same thing with this guy, and I'll do it orange since that's what our main color's been, and I'll bring it down to 50. Boom, 50, there we go. And now it's time to add some icons to these. So let's search again, and maybe this particular section is about research. So I'll search for research and then click on graphics because that's what I'm looking for. And unfortunately, all of these are coming up for the paid version. So I do have a paid version, so I can go ahead and use these, but if you see this little crown, that means you have to be a Canva for Work user. So let's search for something that you would actually be able to use if you're not paying. And searching for book, we have a couple of free ones. So these three are free. So maybe we'll try using this one and we'll change the color to white. And we'll make it a little smaller. And then we can just click and drag. So we could put it in the center or we could put it more towards the top. We'll put it towards the top like that. And then we can insert a text box right over here. A normal text box, a bit of text. We can click and drag this up here, And this is going to be where our content is inserted. So I can go ahead and make this nice and big. And that's a good margin. And then we can go ahead and have plenty of space for our text. Of course, when you click and drag like that, it'll automatically size up the text. So we probably want our text to be somewhere around 16. And then we can go ahead and copy this and bring the text box down here for our other section and center it up. And then that way we can just copy and paste in our text and put any images that we want. And let's say, let's go find another icon to put here. We're still talking about research, so let's say globe. And here's one of the world, so we'll go ahead and click on that. We'll change the color to white again. We'll click and drag it down, and then we'll go ahead and put it inside of here. Come on. There we go. You always want to play with the shapes or position. Maybe we want it kind of half off like this. I kind of like how that looks. And so we'll go full screen here so you can see the finished product. So here's another example of what you can do with your page design. So you can see there's a lot you can do here. And these two really are kind of like my go-to favorite ones, either doing something like this or doing something like this. So to quickly summarize what we've done, the first thing we did is we came in here and we looked for the book cover templates, and we found two book cover templates. So we have this one right here, five-step content machine, that is just with an icon. And then we have this second one that has a stock background photo. Of course, you can go to unsplash.com, pixels.com, or pixabay.com to find free photos for your ebooks. And then we went ahead and created a table of contents. Not my best work, but you can go through the templates yourself. And I also showed you how to import it from another design so you don't have to come up with a table of contents from scratch. And then finally, we have two different ways you can lay out your pages, just a very basic layout like this, or if you want to be a little more involved, we can do the bars on the side and use icons to really just spruce up the content. What's really important with these last pages is making sure that it does not distract from your content, right? Because after the first two pages, your cover and your table of contents, the actual content pages can be very simple and very basic. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video informative and actionable, and most importantly, got some ideas for how to create your own ebooks using Canva 2.0. I'm very interested what you come up with. Go ahead and comment below if you have any questions on designing your ebook inside of Canva. Hit that like button, subscribe, and as always, keep building the business you love.